Welcome back, students. In this session, we are going to understand the various units of time and then how to convert these various units. So the time can be represented as seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, and then years. So these are the usual representation. So the important relationships which you are going to notice is 1 minute equal to 60 seconds. First, 1 day, 1 hour will be 60 minutes. Now 24 hours is 1 day, 7 days is 1 week, 4 weeks generally is 1 month, 1 year has 52 weeks. days are there in 1 year. So this general relationship students have to remember. So this is very, very important. The days of the week are Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, which is known. The 12 months are there. So one more important concept is, like, some months, see, although there are 12 months, some months have 30 days, and some months have 31 days, and some few months have 28 or 29 days. So how to remember that which months have 30 days? So the months which have 30 days is September, April, June, and November. So 31 days is there in all. February has 28 or 29 days. In all other months, you have 31 days. That is January, March, May, July, August, October, and December. So leap year. So this is one important concept which you have to remember. So September, April, June, November has 30 days. January, March, May, July, August, October, December has 31 days. February has 28 or 29 days. The leap year is 1 day more than the regular year. The regular year has 365 days. The leap year has 366 days. So, but how to find out whether the given year is a leap year or not? For that, you have to just adapt a simple test. Like the year, like for example, if it is 1988, whether it is leap year or not, just take the last two digits, check whether they are divisible by 4. So here it is divisible by 4. So clearly, this is a leap year. Let us take 1992, whether this is a leap year. Take the last two digits. Yes, this is divisible by 4. It is a leap year. 1943, not a leap year. So with this, students have understood all the basic units and the basic notations which are used in time conversion. Now, let us do some important questions or important methods which are there in this. The first type of problem is convert to days. Let us take 2 months. How many days are there in 1 month? If it is not given, you assume that it has 30 days. So that will be 2 into 30, it will be 60 days. 5 months, it will be 5 into 60, 300 days. 6 weeks, 1 week has 7 days. So that will be 42 days. Ten weeks, 7 days, 70 days. The second type of problem is convert to days, but you have little bit more advanced type of problems. You will get something like 2 months, 2 days. How will you do this? 2 months will be 2 into 60 days plus 2, that is this 2. So this will be 120, 30 days, 60 plus 2, that will be 62. Six months, 10 days, 6 into 30 is 10, 180, 10, that will be 190. Five weeks is 5 into 7, 4 days, that will be 35 days plus 4, 39 days. So now let me come to the next type of problems. Convert to minutes. Three hours, so just multiply by 60. 180 minutes. 2 hours, 10 minutes. It will be 2 into 60 plus 10. 120 plus 10, 130 minutes. 5 hours, 5 minutes, 5 into 60 plus 5, will be 300 plus 5, 305 minutes. 6 hours, 6 minutes, 6 into 60 plus 5, 360 plus 5, 360 minutes. So very easy to answer this question. The next type of problems is convert to seconds. Three minutes to second, so just multiply by 60, get 180 seconds. 10 minutes, multiply by 60, you will get 600 seconds. 2 minutes, 7 seconds will be 2 into 60 plus 7 will be 120 plus 7, 127 seconds. Now we are going to take the next type of problems where we are going to convert to hours. So convert to hours, 3 days is given. How will you convert? Just multiply into 24, it will be 72 hours. 5 days, multiply into 24, 120 hours. So very easy. So using this relationships, we can find the answer very fast. The next important concept is to check whether a given year is a leap year or not. So for checking a year is leap year or not, just compare the last two digits, see whether it is divisible by 4. 80 is divisible by 4, so it is a leap year. 1982, 82, not divisible, not leap year. 1984, compare the last two digits, leap year, because it is divisible by 4. 1986, not a leap year. How many days are there in a leap year? It is 366 days. How many days are there in a non-leap year? It is 365 days. How many days were there in February 1980? This is a tricky question. First, find out whether this is a leap year or not. This is a leap year. So, clearly there are 29 days here. How many days were there in 1980? Clearly this is a leap year. So there will be 366 days. Don't mention it as 365 days. So such questions are very, very tricky. So students, with that, we have understood all the types of problems in conversion of various units of time. Now you can practice the worksheet that has been given to you. Thank you, students.